Hello and welcome back to Let's Play the Darkside Detective Blind. I'm the RPG Chick, now beginning the last of the bonus episodes. Oh, the last of the episodes entirely. Bates Motel. Last episode was like 17 minutes long. Hopefully this one will be longer. It's Dooley's birthday, so I'm taking him to Twin Lakes' number one roadside attraction to celebrate. A motel? Bates Motel. Exciting? Or excited? Boy, am I. This is such a neat way to spend my birthday. I can't believe Chief Scully gave us the time off work. I have a lot more sway with the chief than you might think. You didn't tell her, did you? No, but perk of the job, I told her El Chupacabra was causing trouble out here. Is that a gang? Point is, we're not expected back at the office for a few days, so let's get there and kick back. I can't believe it's taken us so long to come to Twin Lakes' finest roadside attraction. Oh, I get it. It's a different kind of Bates. Not just spelled differently. The finest and only attraction. I'm excited to see what sort of stuff has been fished up from Lake Monster and stored here. And I'm excited to find out why they're taken all the way out here to the desert and not stored near the lake itself. Anyway, let's grab our bags from the car and sort out our room at reception before we go visit the museum. Oh, there's a museum. So much neon. It's so you can't see how crummy this place is. Aw, I know where my best buddy brings me for my birthday could be crummy. Aw. I can't believe we were able to get into such an exclusive establishment. I think you may want to rein in those expectations, buddy. Okay, this is a diner, road, squad car. Dooley, why did you bring a lamp? We're only here for the night, so I figured I'd pack light. Just that and some power supplements in case I want to work out while we're here. I love you, buddy. Don't ever change. I try not to. It's why I'm wrapping my uniform on. It's why I'm wearing my uniform on holidays. I cannot read today. Luggage. We have it. I know it seems like a lot to pack for one night, but you can never be too prepared. If you're a blood wolf, you won't be prepared at all. I've only packed workout supplements and a torn-up phone book. And a lantern. Okay, reception's in there. I've got a trash can. A trash can full of old burrito wrappers and half-full energy drink cans. That's a potent drink. It lets you see sounds and hear your heart beatbox. Why would anyone want that? I don't know. Quests and stuff? So the rooms are that way. Vacancy sign. I have us booked in. Didn't want to risk there being no rooms left in the inn. Inn? It's a motel, detective. What if we go to the road? We should drop off our bags to the room first. If I just drop them here, can we go see the attraction right away? Guess not. Rooms, reception, I'm so glad this place has aircon. It's so warm out in the desert. Aircon. Stop taking all my cool air. Your room has its own cool air. Go breathe in there. You're raising the temperature level in here. Narvin? Oh, he's friendly. Fish trophy. I caught that fish myself. You ain't never caught one that big, have you? No, that's for sure. What are you watching? None of your business, that's what. Jeez. I'm half a mind to leave right now. Did you know the first reception was built in Ohio by Julius Caesar in 932 BC? What history books are you reading? Wait, you can read about history? That ain't for no customer's use. It's for when I want to fax my mutter, make sure she fed the cat. She ain't never remembers to feed that damn cat. Every night I come home to it screaming at her, and her screaming at it. Just feed the damn cat, Ma. Why are you using a fax machine for that? I don't want to talk to her. Don't want to talk to you either. Someone has an attitude problem. Hey, that water's not for drinking. Really? What do I look like, a unicorn to you? Of course, really. It's my water. You want water? You go to the diner next door. Jeez. The desert, a one-stop destination for all your poorly conceived spiritual journeys. Alright, so... you've looked at everything. Eh! Close the frickin' door, you're letting all the sand in. Why are you here, anyway? We're here for the attraction. Then you're in the wrong place, moron. This here is a motel, as you should have been able to see from the motel sign out front. Not so good at the detectiving for a detective, eh? Attraction is back out on the main road. Then follow the sign. You'll know you're near on account of the localized sandstorm. Localized sandstorm? That's what I said, ain't it? Now you think that a smart guy like you can handle all that? Wow. We have a room booked here. So you're the guys. I was wondering if you were going to turn up. It's late. You're late. You're in room two. Thanks. Don't thank me. I didn't clean the place out after the last guest. Wonderful. Got a room key. A key to our room. That's no way to spend a vacation. Before we go to the room, let's check the laundry. I guess this is a lot like relaxing at the museum slash poolside. I'm sorry, buddy. Wailing whites. Leaves your sheets wide enough for even the pickiest haunting. If I have to wash anything, then this will not feel like a holiday. True. As a kid, I used to love those giant bubble machines. The right mix of detergent and kitchen supplies always cover the place with suds. Now my sister makes me use a laundromat. I wonder why. Why would I want or need a basket full of other people's socks on holiday? Because you're weird. How come these things always seem to eat one sock? I'm not sure. That may be a case for a quiet week. Why would I need one lonely hanger? Dark corner. Hey, I hide my dirty clothes in the dark, too. Alright, so there's nothing we need here yet. What was the room number? Two. It was two. It's not that hard to remember. Two. Now get. Jeez. What if I try to give him the keys back? Nope. Take our luggage. Do I have to? Okay, there are the rooms. Let's go to the rooms. It's too dark to see anything inside. Do you think I have a head for hats? I was thinking of trying to wear hats more often. You're already wearing a hat. You're always wearing a hat. Your police hat. Sure, but I have to wear this for work. I was thinking of a stylish hat. Oh, for off-duty? Huh? No, to wear over this one. On-duty is when I meet the most new people, so I want to try to look my best, you know? Okay, then. Room 1. Well, we're not in room 1. Can we go in there? Not us. We're one over. Alright. Maybe we should close the curtains. It's full of out-of-date shampoo and toothpaste. All the food items are gone. Doesn't look like this is all that well maintained. Much like all non-military services in this country. Oh look, there's a bag of cheese puffs in the slot. Might as well take it. These things never go off. These things never go off? Oh, like, expire? Contains no cheese. I'm not sure that's going to achieve anything. Now, we could go in there, but let's see what's down here. The curtains are pulled over. I can't see inside. Not us. Swimming pool. Okay, let's go this way. This is us. Let's unlock it and go in. I have to manually do this. Here we are. Finally! I feel like we've been walking forever and seeing nothing. Not been walking forever. Okay, this is us. Let's dump our bags. We have a steering wheel for some reason. No expense spared on this room, eh? Sorry, Dooley. It's all I could afford. Huh? No, I'm serious. I love it. Thanks, Detective. Oh, I'm glad. I've seen these before. It's the AI that controls the ship. Hello? Are you there? They must have let its battery run down. Good. I don't want it watching me sleep. Oh, Jesus. Can't look at the fan. Light switch. Phone. Anything in the dresser? Seems like a good place to put our bags. Aircon. Air conditioning. Yeah, but why do they call it... I've never heard anyone call it aircon. Thank goodness there's aircon. This desert heat would be stifling otherwise. I don't think I could stay indoors without it. I know we're supposed to put our luggage there, but let's just see here. There's a note saying, I owe you one Bible, signed Pastor Farrelly. Vibrating bed? It's one of those 50 cents vibrating finger beds. Hello, gorgeous. We have half a phone. Oh yeah, the receiver's missing. But is the phone half empty or the half phone half full? This is not connected to anything. I guess we're sleeping with the lights on. Alright. Luggage. Okay, that's us settled in. Shall we go see the attraction now? Yes, finally. Our luggage. I can't believe all you brought was protein supplements. Really? Are you sure you can't believe it? Actually, yeah, I can believe it. Want some? I got enough to share. Not right now, thanks. So we can leave. Let's check out the swimming pool. Oh, there's a person here. This brings back bad memories. Oh yeah, the life ring. Look at those flies go. Probably drying themselves off after a swim. Just look at that water. Chemical blue is the name, I think. I'm glad I brought trunks. I'm glad I like skinny dipping. A bucket of highly chlorinated water from the pool. You want to watch that stuff. They say it's good for your teeth, but really it's so the sheeple don't rise up against the government. Dooley, you're thinking of fluoride, which is not used for mind control. Also, you shouldn't be putting chlorine anywhere near your mouth. It's toxic. Oh. That might explain the horrible taste in my mouth each morning. Jesus. Relaxed man. Ladder? No. Lights. Stars. Okay. What are you doing out here at this hour? Sunbathing. It's nighttime. I don't want to get sunburned. Daytime is when the rays are out hunting. Okay, utility room. I'm glad I got to see this. I missed out on the last boiler room. It's a beauty, all right. Are you going to clean the donut crumbs out of the car, finally? Dooley, you left those crumbs there. Is that a no, then? It's like a witch's broom for a damper kind of witch. The circuit breaker for the motel. This must be where the motel heats its water in rooms. Pool, too, I guess. I'll have to keep this stuff in mind. There's nothing else to do here. Okay, well... We want to go to the attraction, but I want to check out the diner. I'm hungry, damn it. Bowie Meads Grill. This sign is painted on. I guess they're open 24/7. Those are my kind of opening hours. I can't believe we were able to get into such an exclusive establishment. I think you may want to read the same thing you said before. The age-old love story. When the lights go out, I was supposed to see something. B-O-B-U. Bumped. Bumped real. Alright, so we're going. Oh, behind the diner we can go too. K Can we stop what we're doing and order one of everything, please? Sue says, order whatever you want, boys. Yes. But remember, the cook only really knows how to bake cookies. Aw. Wait, what? It's like a processed torpedo coming right from my heart. Mustard and ketchup, the two genders. What? I need some of those to wipe the drool from my mouth. Ugh. Perfect for carrying meals, hitting muggers on the head, and impromptu games of frisbee. How is it? It's rats and mice. You know, proper pastry. Right, of course. It's all that stuff. Of course it is. I hope the burgers here are as good as they look. Are they ever? Not in Twin Lakes, honey. The mayor ruled all food has to be worse than advertised. Keeps the population dissatisfied. Customer, waitress... seats... We can actually go in the kitchen as well. Welcome, boys. Can I fix you up with a little something to eat? Norvin. Yeah. Are you the boss here? I surely am, though it's only me and Klaus, and we're closed off season, so it's not that fancy a setup. Keeps my lights up and his lights on and his workshop running, so... Wait, forget I said anything. What's that about the workshop? Are you linked to the motel? Gracious, no. I don't think Norvin would want to work with others. He's not what would you call a people person. Why is Norvin in a public-facing job? The way I heard it, family business. His mom fished, his pa ran the place. He got stuck with it for some reason or another, but I think he likes the power. I think he wanted to get his hands on the real abuse of authority and become police, but it didn't work out. Hey! If they give me a shrug animation, this is when I'd use it. Y'all come back now, you hear? Vince says, all right, shoppers. Shoppers? It's rhyming slang for coppers. Is it? I don't know. Trying to butter churn it. Learn it. Right. Doesn't sound like it's going all that well. No. What brings you out here? Trying to promote our road show, Lady Farnival's Frivolous Carnivals. Wait, is that slang or what it's called? I don't know anymore. See you later, Perspective. Perspective. Check out the kitchen. Fry cook. Vent. Seems to be broken. I hope no critters get in here. Me too, Klaus says. We'd have to close down and wait for a fumigation if they did. Dooley says, what I wouldn't do to have a kitchen like this at home. Fry cook, condiments. I guess a place like this can never have too many sauces. Some yeast. Yeasts for making burger buns and other stuff rise and expand. My desire for a burger is rising and expanding as we stand here. Maybe I should... hold it there. You can't just take my yeast. I need it for making Christmassy and other more year-long types of cakes. So it's not Klaus, it's Klaus. Syrup. A jar of maple syrup. Now I just need a stack of pancakes. This could work well as a makeshift glue. Not a chance. I know what you're like, young fella, because I never met you before. Did you know that outside of America people don't call this jelly? They call it jam. And jelly is what we call jello. Jelly is what we call jello. What? Here jam means stuck, but also there it means stuck as well as jelly. Language is zany. Yeah, I'd hate to be a non-American trying to capture even a loose glimpse of their culture. Well, as us Americans are always saying, when in Rome, Monday morning quarterback. I could not agree more. What? Some weighing scales. They don't look used. I'm an artist. I guess the amounts. And the elves help. I mean, Merry Cookmas. Oh, drat. So we're not supposed to know that he's Santa Claus or something. So I guess he is Santa Claus? It's full of Christmas cookies. It's my signature dish. So the vent... Yeah, critters... Food processor. A shiny food blender for sauces and shakes. And seasonal items such as eggnog. Just an example. I think we should check it for clues. Alright. So we're done in here. Except for talking to him. Hey, I know you. You're Santa Claus. Eh. No, I'm not. I'm somebody else. Yes. Somebody else entirely. What are you doing here? I'm just a guy with bills to pay, just like you. Heating bills, am I right? Maybe. Season's greetings. Whatever they might be. Alright. Alright, behind the diner. Oh, one of these rats. Hey there, Lip. Whoa, fast one, aren't you? Okay. The vent into the kitchen. Okay, well, it can come through there, which isn't good. Standard diner waste. Imagine a witch jumped out from behind this bin, and we both had heart attacks and died. Right. No more scary movies for you before bed. Aww. Old car. So that was a look at. An abandoned car. Looks like there's a discarded cross wrench in a trunk. I prefer my wrench is happy. Let's take it and cheer it up. Yeah, we can't cheer that up. A wrench with a different size socket on each of the four ends. Okay, let's go the road to this attraction then. If it's still open. Attraction. Billboard truck. A carnival is coming to Twin Lakes? What are we doing at this dump? I mean, thanks for the thoughtful birthday trip. It's a shame that signs are the fanciest part of this place. Desert attraction. So desert is back where we came from. Oh. Nope. Ruff! Look, detectives. He's waiting. Look, detective, he's waving. Oh, it's an anthill. I thought this was a road with, like, cars going up and down. A hill made of ants. Close, buddy. Close. Oh, the moon again. For once, I'm glad to see you, moon. It'd be very dark if we were out here on our own. Looks like a football. Just don't kick it. Want some cheesy poofs? Attack it with the cross wrench. Nope. Nothing like that dry desert air. You can really feel the sand in your nostrils. Did I talk to him here? What a beautiful night. You never really see the moon in the city. Dooley, we see it all the time. Most nights. Oh? I never really look up in the city, on account of not being able to see anything when I do. Parking lot. Okay, that's the parking lot. Alright, so let's go to the attraction, finally. Ah, I didn't think it was this much of a walk. That'll be good for us. I wonder what that haze in the distance is. What's going on here? This place is called Trout of This World. Yeah, the localized sandstorm the waitress mentioned. Think it's part of the attraction? I don't, Dooley. I don't. It's a sandstorm, but why is it centered on the attraction? Does this mean... Yes, Dooley, a case to investigate. Say it isn't so. Sandstorm. There's a sandstorm centered on the attraction's entrance. If we want to get inside to investigate, we'll need to find a way to block it. So we can't look at anything other than the sandstorm. Well, except for information. Does the storm look nice, Detective? I can't see with all the sand in my eyes. The information stand seems to be closed down because of the storm. We can't get in while that sandstorm is blocking the way. We need to cut the storm off. Do I have to? So it looks like a fishing rod or something with the Santa Claus's boot. I wonder if this could block the wind causing that sandstorm. Maybe we can block the sandstorm with this. We need to fix the, with the wrench? Oh. So we need to get in it. Or push it. Where can I get the keys for that truck out front? Does this here place to you look like a carnival? Sorry? I ask you, does this place look like a carnival? No? Then why do you think I own a carnival advertising truck? It belongs to some other poor schmuck staying here. So it's either the guy at the swimming pool or the guy at the diner. Let's try the swimming pool. I guess it's not him. Is that your truck out front? My what? Your truck. Your rubber duck? Oh yeah, my rubber duck. It's parked out on the indecipherable code. Indecipherable code? Road? Can I borrow your bee's knees? Ooh, if you want the bee's knees, then I'll want something in return. A garden hermit. One for my arsenal is set up in your circus clown. Wait. A garden hermit. Hermit? One for my arsenal to set up in your circus clown? Okay, sure. Sorry, what? If you want my truck keys, I need a permit so my carnival can set up in your town, mate. A permit? Yeah, okay, I understood at that time. Right, off I go to phone the precinct. So I phone him with this. I think we have all we need from here. Where do I phone the... Guess go to my room? Get my phone? Well, that won't work. Maybe we go ask the guy to use his phone. He's not going to let us. I need it for police business. Fine, but you got 30 seconds, I swear. Dialing. Dispatch. Sally, it's me. I need a... Who's me? Sally, it's Detective McQueen. We work together, we're friends. Well, if we're such good friends, then how come you didn't ask who I was first? Straight into business. I can go the business route too, you know. I'm sorry, Sally, that was rude of me. How are you? Busy. Too busy for idle chatter. What's up? God. Can you ask the chief to sign a permit so a carnival can come to Twin Lakes? No need. I have pre-signed permits here. Consider it done. Why do you sign permits just sitting around? Look, do you want the permit, or do you want to ask questions? Permit, please. I'll fax it to you. Cool, printing. Technology. Got a permit. A permit for the carnival. I don't need to use it again. Besides, I don't want to anger the owner again. Damn right you don't. Keep your myth to yourself. Does he say anything new? Nope. I have your permit. Sorry, you're... What was it? You're something-something hermit. Oh, that's a week-long cruise. Good news. Here are my rubber duck's bee's knees, truck's keys. I appreciate it, but I have to ask, why are you trying to talk like this? Seems like a lot of hassle. It adds an air of authenticity, doesn't it? Does it, though? Got truck keys. The keys to the billboard truck parked outside the motel. Vroom. Hop in, Dooley. Let's go block that sandstorm. Okay, the truck has blocked enough of the storm to get us near the entrance. This is exciting. Usually people are struggling to get out of museums. I just want to see something over here. We can go up now. It revealed a ladder, which we could see, but now we can actually point at it. Ooh, a light. Those lights are so low-flying planes and UFOs don't crash into towers. This must be where the motel gets its TV signal. Okay. Why do we always find ourselves so high up? Alright, let's go down. This seems like a better place to promote the carnival. Two birds, one stone, all of that. Museum rules. 1. No licking. Items, building, or other attendees. Oh, the person opened the information booth. Oh, it was probably that same lady from the campsite, too. 2. Theft of display items. Only okay for supernatural investigations. And 3. No lake monsters. We can get past this now. Hopefully we'll find the cause inside. I'm sure we will. It looks like a prison. It used to be one. Then they started fishing up interesting stuff from Lake Monster, so they released all the criminals to store the stuff here. Makes sense. Information. Welcome to Trout of This World, the Twin Lakes Twin Lake Findings Museum. Jamie, was that her name? Hello again. Hello again to you, too. Long time no see. That's gotta be her, then. You don't remember me, do you? I'm afraid that this is where you have caught me out. Please forgive me. In my job as tourism officer of Twin Lakes, I meet literally tens of people a year. Try though I do, I cannot remember them all. Tens of people. What was that storm about? You know, I often wonder the same thing about storms. And blizzards. Heat waves, too. What is it about? What's it all about? But what about this one? Ah, Jamie, this one. This one will come and they will ask you about, I told myself. Sadly, I had stepped out to the bathroom. All I know is that a fisherman came to see the place, and by the time the storm came, he was gone. What did he look like? Yellow hair and a mustache, and fisherman clothes, as in clothes that smell like fish. So that must be his rod. Captured Santa's boot? It looks like Santa's boot. What can you tell me about this place? While despite numerous warnings, many people go to Lake Monster to fish, of course the very real monster has almost certainly eaten all of the fish. With probably no fish to catch, people dredge up old boots, license plates, terrible artifacts of power, and reverse bicycles. In case they're of value, the mayor wants them all catalogued. And in case they belong to the terrible lake fiend, I, as the head of tourism, store them as far from the lake as I can. When something is found, I drive it over here. Wait, reverse bicycles? Yes, the frame is made of inflated rubber and the wheels are metal. Local inventor Claudia Rott invented them to reduce bike congestion across the city. Do you have any merchandise? Oh yes, we sell boots modeled on boots found in the lake. They're very uncomfortable. We also have t-shirts soaked in lake water to give them a unique pungent smell. And hats with our logo on them. Oh, a hat! I want a hat. One hat for the birthday boy, please. Coming right up. So when you said a logo on it, I meant we have built miniature versions of our logo on top, yes. I love it. Assuming this is supposed to be here? It looks like a prison. Okay. Alright. Guess we're going in. Okay, let's dig our way in. So far, I'm digging this case.